on, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing another spell for you guys. I am currently have been working with a client, and we are finally at the last stages of this. Now, I do want to make a disclaimer. If you're not looking for a bit of a difficult type of elaborate spell, then this spell is definitely not for you. It does take a lot of ingredients. It is a process. So if you're looking for something quick, this is definitely not the spell for you. But I also do want to, like I said, make a disclaimer that this spell is a very powerful, strong spell. We do work with a saint, which is San Simon, Saint Simon. So if you don't feel comfortable, you can use, you know, whatever entity you work with, whatever deity. I work personally with spirits and with my saint. So the spirits are invoked to be able to render results, and the saint serves as the master to the spirits. So if you guys want to know more about working with saints and working with specific spirits, then go ahead and comment below, let me know, and I'll make sure to make a video about that. But for now, we're going to try to get to this as quickly as possible, explain to you guys the process. Again, like I said, intention is everything, but more than anything, this spell is a very powerful spell. So make sure that when you're doing this spell, there's no hesitation, there is no doubt, or there's no fear. Fear is very important to not have for these specific type of spells, okay? All right, so what we're going to need, I'm going to tell you guys rather quickly. You're going to need some parchment paper for the petition and for the names. You can also use pictures, but ideally for this specific spell, I prefer to use the parchment, as throughout the years, I've noticed it gives quicker results with the parchment versus with the pictures. So again, just letting you guys know, but you can use pictures if you prefer. Now, you're going to be needing some type of sage, some type of cleansing, type of incense or smudging. It's going to be very important to make sure to clear out any type of energies before the spell work and after the spell work. It's very important. Now, for those of you guys that don't really know how to prepare yourselves when it comes to spell work, especially when we're talking about spell works that are more elaborate, that there is a ritual involved, then if you don't know how to go about that, there's some videos that I've made of how to protect yourself. But I also do want to let you guys know, if you guys want to go to my online store, you'll be able to find all the ingredients that we're using here. For this specific spell, to prepare yourself, I would highly encourage you guys to get the black cat soap, as that is specifically for these types of spell works, to raise our vibration, to be able to be 100% focused in what we're doing, but also it serves as an instrument to be able to go into the spell work with a clear mind and clear energy, which is very important. You can also use the Handsome Devil for you men out there that are doing this spell, or for women, the Jezebel soap after the ritual is completed. I would highly encourage you guys to use that as well, to really see the results and the power behind this ritual itself. Okay. All right. So what we're going to be needing, like I said, some type of incense or smudging, ideally sage or frankincense or, dragon's blood. Parchment paper. Now we're going to be using a coconut, and it has to be a fresh coconut that you get at the grocery store. This is going to be the representation of the head. So again, you're going to be needing coconut. You're also going to be needing thyme. We're doing this for a woman client. So this is work for a male, for her partner. So we're using thyme here, but if you're using this for a woman and you're doing this work for a specific woman, then instead of using thyme, you would use either lavender or you would use hibiscus flower. Okay. All right. Now we're going to be using vervain. I've already explained to you guys, when it comes to vervain is a almost it brings the power and the intensity of that of cemetery dirt. I prefer to use vervain when it comes to love work. If it's not specifically a binding, then we don't use cemetery dirt. We use the vervain. I feel that it gives stronger but more clarity of intention when we use the vervain for love spells. Okay, now we're also going to be using angelica root, and we're also going to be using the buckthorn bark. Okay, this is for wish fulfillments and to be able to experience the I'm not sure if you can see. Oh, left it open. This way. For wish fulfillment, as well as to be able to remove any blockages that we're currently experiencing. Okay. All right. When it comes to oils, we're going to be using Dove's blood oil. Now, you guys can shop online, or you guys can go to your, like, any type of Latin botanical shop. You'll be able to find on there Dove's blood oil. You can use that. I don't want to get into this because a lot of the time, I know some people could be very sensitive to this, but I do practice partly Santeria. So again, just letting you guys know, you know, just putting it out there. This is not necessarily oil, if you catch my drift. Okay. What we're also going to be needing is we're going to be needing some type of powder, love powder. So for this, we're going to be using our Do As I Say powder. And it's a mixture of Do As I Say as well as Follow Me powder. You guys can find these online on my online store. And we're also going to be using honey. Okay. We're going to be using spirit powder. Now, I'm not sure if you guys are aware or know how to work with spirit powder, but spirit powder is usually used when it's used when we cannot have some type of, like, their person property. Like, an example, if you can't get their hair, if you can't get their nails, if you can't have, like, if you literally have nothing to go off of, only that their name and their information. So we use the the spirit powder to be able to pull in their physical energy. Okay, so we're going to be using that. We're also going to be using licorice root. I've mentioned this on multiple occasions on my channel. Licorice root is extremely powerful. It is one of the most, if not one of the most powerful and important ingredients for any witch's cabinet. The reason I say that is because it has a bountiful of uses, not just for love, not just for money, not just for abundance. You can use it for all kinds of spells. So again, there you go. Okay, so what we're also going to be needing is we're going to be needing black marker for the petition. And we're going to be needing some Play-Doh. It could be any type of Play-Doh. It does not matter. The reason why we're going to use this is, well, obviously I will explain throughout the video, but just putting it out there, Play-Doh is important. It does not matter the color. Okay. All right. So obviously I've already been working on this client for a while. So as you guys can see here, let me make sure not to show their information. But I've been working with this client for a couple of days now, and this is basically the last step. So that's why you guys can see that it's a bit dirty. So anyways, okay, so what we're going to need, we're also going to be needing a red candle. Now, like I said, we've been working with this client for a while, and we're just going to be melting this wax into the coconut, but I'll show you guys. But you will be needing a red candle. And finally, the very important ingredient as well, St. Simon's candle, San Simon. Now, like I said, you guys can go to any Latin botanical shop. You'll be able to find his candles there. You can also go on my online store. You'll be able to find it there. But it is important to have something that represents him. Now, we work with what we got. If there's no possible way that you can come into getting or possessing a candle of his, then I would encourage you to get a yellow candle and to print out an image of him to be able to incorporate that into your spell work, okay? Now, keep in mind, when we're doing or when we're talking about spell work, it's not about taking the easy route. Obviously, if you go out of your way to try to get his candle, it just shows it shows the respect and it shows that you're putting effort towards trying to achieve what you're asking for. So he takes great notice of that, just putting it out there. He's a very strong tempered saint. So make sure that when you're doing this type of work, especially when you're incorporating him in your spell work, make sure to have 100% faith in him. Be loyal to him. And it is very important that when we get the results that we're looking for, when you're dedicating your work to him, it is very important to promise him something in return. It could be, you know, I promise you that I will light you three candles for, you know, three consecutive days, or I promise you that I will buy you a cigar. That's something that he loves, as well as cigarettes. I will, you know, offer you, you know, five cigarettes or even a whole carton, a box, a carton of cigarettes. I will offer that to you once you give me the results. Like I said, he's very fierce when it comes to giving you exactly what you petition, but he also is very fierce when it comes to collecting. So putting it out there. Okay. All right. So what we're going to do is, hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing another spell for you guys. I am currently have been working with a client and we are finally at the last stages of this. Now, I do want to make a disclaimer. If you're not looking for a bit of a difficult type of elaborate spell, then this spell is definitely not for you. It does take a lot of ingredients. It is a process. So if you're looking for something quick, this is definitely not the spell for you. But I also do want to, like I said, make a disclaimer that this spell is a very powerful, strong spell. We do work with a saint, which is San Simon, Saint Simon. So if you don't feel comfortable, you can use, you know, whatever entity you work with, whatever deity. I work personally with spirits and with my saint. So the spirits are invoked to be able to render results, and the saint serves as the master to the spirits. So if you guys want to know more about working with saints and working with specific spirits, then go ahead and comment below. Let me know, and I'll make sure to make a video about that. But for now, we're going to try to get to this as quickly as possible, explain to you guys the process. Again, like I said, intention is everything, but more than anything, this spell is a very powerful spell. So make sure that when you're doing this spell, there is no hesitation, there is no doubt, or there's no fear. Fear is very important to not have for these specific type of spells, okay? All right, so what we're going to need, I'm going to tell you guys rather quickly. You're going to need some parchment paper for the petition and for the names. You can also use pictures, but ideally for this specific spell, I prefer to use the parchment, as I've, you know, throughout the years, I've noticed it gives quicker results with the parchment versus with the pictures. So again, just letting you guys know, but you can use pictures if you prefer. Now, you're going to be needing some type of sage, some type of cleansing, type of incense, or smudging. It's going to be very important to make sure to clear out any type of energies before the spell work and after the spell work. It's very important. Now, for those of you guys that don't really know how to prepare yourselves when it comes to spell work, especially when we're talking about spell works that are more elaborate, that there is a ritual involved, then if you don't know how to go about that, there's some videos that I've made of how to protect yourself. But I also do want to let you guys know, if you guys want to go to my online store, you'll be able to find all the ingredients that we're using here. For this specific spell, to prepare yourself, I would highly encourage you guys to get the black cat soap, as that is specifically for these types of spell works, to raise our vibration, to be able to be 100% focused in what we're doing, but also it serves as an instrument to be able to go into the spell work with a clear mind and clear energy, which is very important. You can also use the Handsome Devil for you men out there that are doing this spell, or for women, the Jezebel soap after the ritual is completed. I would highly encourage you guys to use that as well, to really see the results and the power behind this ritual itself. Okay. All right. So what we're going to be needing, like I said, some type of incense or smudging, ideally sage or frankincense or, dragon's blood. Parchment paper. Now we're going to be using a coconut, and it has to be a fresh coconut that you get at the grocery store. This is going to be the representation of the head. So again, you're going to be needing coconut. You're also going to be needing thyme. We're doing this for a woman client, so this is work for a male, for her partner. So we're using thyme here, but if you're using this for a woman and you're doing this work for a specific woman, then instead of using thyme, you would use either lavender or you would, use hibiscus flower. Okay. All right. Now we're going to be using vervain. I've already explained to you guys, when it comes to vervain, vervain is it brings the power and the intensity of that of cemetery dirt. I prefer to use vervain when it comes to love work. If it's not specifically a binding, then we don't use cemetery dirt. We use the vervain. I feel that it gives stronger, but more clarity of intention when we use the vervain for love spells. Okay. Now we're also going to be using Angelica root. And we're also going to be using the buckthorn bark. Okay. This is for wish fulfillments and to be able to, experience the, I'm not sure if you can see, left it open this way, for wish fulfillment, as well as, to be able to remove any blockages that we're currently experiencing. Okay. All right, when it comes to oils, we're going to be using Dove's blood oil. Now, you guys can shop online, or you guys can go to your, like, any type of Latin botanical shop. You'll be able to find on there Dove's blood oil. You can use that. I don't want to get into this because a lot of the time, I know some people could be very sensitive to this, but I do practice partly Santeria. So again, just letting you guys know, you know, just putting it out there, this is not necessarily oil, if you catch my drift. Okay. What we're also going to be needing is we're going to be needing some type of powder, love powder. So for this, we're going to be using our Do As I Say powder. And it's a mixture of Do As I Say as well as Follow Me powder. You guys can find these online on my online store. And we're also going to be using honey. Okay. We're going to be using spirit powder. Now, I'm not sure if you guys are aware or know how to work with spirit powder. But spirit powder is usually used when... it's used when we cannot have some type of like their person property. Like an example, if you can't get their hair, if you can't get their nails, if you can't have like, if you literally have nothing to go off of, only that their name and their information. So we use the, we use the spirit powder to be able to pull in their physical energy, okay? So we're gonna be using that. We're also going to be using licorice root. I've mentioned this on multiple occasions on my channel. Licorice root is extremely powerful. It is one of the most, if not one of the most powerful and important ingredients for any witch's cabinet. the reason I say that is because it has a bountiful of uses, not just for love, not just for money, not just for abundance. You can use it for all kinds of spells. So again, there you go. Okay, so what we're also going to be needing is we're going to be needing black marker for the petition, and we're going to be needing some Play-Doh. It could be any type of Play-Doh, it does not matter. The reason why we're gonna use this is, well, obviously I will explain throughout the video, but just putting it out there, Play-Doh is important. It does not matter the color, okay? All right. So obviously I've already been working on this client for a while. So as you guys can see here, let me make sure not to show their information. But I've been working with this client for a couple of days now, and this is basically the last step. So that's why you guys can see that it's a bit dirty. So anyways, okay, so what we're going to need, we're also going to be needing a red candle. Now, like I said, we've been working with this client for a while, and we're just going to be melting this wax into the coconut, but I'll show you guys. But you will be needing a red candle. And finally, the very important ingredient as well, St. Simon's candle, San Simon. Now, like I said, you guys can go to any Latin botanical shop. You'll be able to find his candles there. You can also go on my online store. You'll be able to find it there. But it is important to have something that represents him. Now, we work with what we got. If there's no possible way that you can come into getting or possessing a candle of his, then I would encourage you to get a yellow candle and to print out an image of him to be able to incorporate that into your spell work, okay? Now, keep in mind, when we're doing or when we're talking about spell work, it's not about taking the easy route. Obviously, if you go out of your way to try to get his candle, it just shows the respect, and it shows that you're putting effort towards trying to achieve what you're asking for. So he takes great notice of that, just putting it out there. He's a very strong tempered saint. So make sure that when you're doing this type of work, especially when you're incorporating him in your spell work, make sure to have 100% faith in him. Be loyal to him. And it is very important that when we get the results that we're looking for, when you're dedicating your work to him, it is very important to promise him something in return. It could be, you know, I promise you that I will light you three candles for, you know, three consecutive days, or I promise you that I will buy you a cigar. That's something that he loves, as well as cigarettes. I will, you know, offer you, you know, five cigarettes, or even a whole carton, a box, a carton of cigarettes. I will offer that to you once you give me the results. Like I said, he's very fierce when it comes to giving you exactly what you petition, but he also is very fierce when it comes to collecting. So putting it out there. Okay. All right. So what we're going to do is the coconut. Now, I do want to let you guys know, this is a 13-day ritual. Yes, you heard right. A 13-day ritual. Now, when you get the coconut, what you're going to do is you're going to get a marker, and you're going to write down your partner or the person of your interest, their first name, last name, and date of birth on the coconut. Now, this spell is particularly, it's a form of obsession as well as a form of binding. It's not binding per se, Binding is a higher form of magic, but this is not, it's a bit stronger than an obsession spell, but a bit less forceful than a binding. So again, you can do this for, you can do this for love, you can do this for work, as an example. If you're dealing with someone that is extremely stubborn or someone that just makes your life difficult, you can use this for that as well. Of course, the ingredients would change. We are specifically focusing on love, so just letting you guys know. Okay, so you're gonna write down their first name, last name, and date of birth. Okay, once that is done, what we're going to do is, let me make sure I don't show their information. Okay, so what we're gonna do is, you would use holy water or consecrated water or moon water in the baptizing of this coconut. Now, when we talk about baptizing, when you're baptizing either a voodoo doll, when you're baptizing a coconut that is a representation of their mind and their literal head, when we consecrate and we baptize, what you're doing is you're bringing it to life. So as an example, I do see a lot of people talk about, you know, when you're trying to hex someone, as an example, and you are basically, you know, they show that they're like a blessing and pretty much baptizing the doll. You're not supposed to bring to life that which you're trying to quote unquote, when you're trying to break them down or when you're trying to kill their spirit or kill their success, their abundance, etc. You're not supposed to bring to life, then therefore to kill. I hope that makes sense. You only baptize certain things when you're trying to bring it life, so therefore you can possess or you can influence them as a person. I hope that makes sense. So basically what I'm saying is, don't believe everything you see on YouTube. Do your research before doing any type of spell work. I've seen this multiple occasions. I've had clients ask me about that, and it kind of, you're going against what you're supposed to be doing, and then they wonder why shit just got real or it got crazy. Just putting it out there. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to baptize the coconut. So again, like I said, you would use holy water. You can get holy water at any church, any Catholic church, or you can use moon water, rain water, consecrated water, holy water, etc. So what you're going to do is, you're pretty much, now I've already done this, but just for showing purposes. So what you do is, you're going to pretty much bathe the coconut in the holy water, okay? And you're going to bless it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I bless and consecrate this coconut as a representation of my... I baptize you on this very night, and you're going to say the first name, last name, and date of birth. On this day of your birth, you're going to say their date of birth. I call upon your archangel, that who was present in your birthing, to assist me, to guide me, and to help me to be able to not bring harm to you, but to bring clarity and to allow you to see me in different eyes, that type of thing, okay? You can... use that or in those lines. Now, what you're going to do then is, once you do that and once you've blessed it and once you've baptized it, what you're going to do is, you're going to get some of the Angelica root. You're going to use some of the Vervain and the Buckthorn bark, and you're going to put it in a plate, okay? Now, that's when you introduce the thyme as well. And what you're going to do is, you're going to get the honey and you're going to pour the honey all over the coconut. and you're going to basically move it around like I am doing right now, and you're going to say the person's name, last name, and their date of birth. This is your mind. This is your head. I move it, I turn it anywhere towards my desire. That's where you turn. That's where you look. That's where your attention goes. I have you in my hands, or I have you, metaphorically speaking, I have you in my possession. It is not your will, but mine's, and that of your desire to give unto me whichever or whatever I request or ask of you. Now, the coconut, the reason why we use the coconut is because it's a very hard, obviously hard shell, right? This is specifically for those that are extremely stubborn, those that are extremely narcissistic, those that really you just can't get through to them. This is what you use. Now, what we're gonna do is, once you start doing this, right, and really focus all your energy and your effort when you're doing this, you are literally having their head in your hands. Wherever it turns, that's where they go. Wherever you call, that's where they come. Okay, so really go with that intention and really put force into it. It's very important for you guys to really feel, like, as an example, if you're doing this for a partner that has multiple times stepped out of the relationship, you're going to keep, you know, doing this and going around it and basically saying, you know, you are mine, you belong to me and only me. No one will ever suffice. No one will ever be enough for you. I don't know if you guys heard that, but some of my herbs in the back just fell. Now, that's not no coincidence. Like I said, when you're doing the spell, this is extremely powerful type of work. All of this is already ritualized and consecrated, just for showing purposes. Now, you may be asking why this tape. The reason for it is because I'll get into it in a bit, but I put it just to show you guys how the coconut would look. Okay. All right. So once that's done, we're going to be doing this for 3 consecutive days. So, every single day. And when do you do this? You are only allowed to do this when the moon is waxing, when it's full moon. I don't suggest for you guys to do this, like, as an example, on the exact full moon, because it is a 13-day process. Ideally, you can also do this like on the new moon. It's working yourself up to the full moon. So again, you're going to do this for 3 consecutive days. Okay. And what you're doing is, like I said, really put force into it, put all your energy and your might into it, because this is the representation of their head. Now, when to do this, ideally, do this at night. So the most powerful time would be 9 p.m. or midnight, which is the witching hour. Once you've done this for a while, what you're going to do now is you're going to ask San Simon, you're going to ask Saint Simon, I ask you to be present to guide me in this spell work, to assist me in breaking down their stubbornness, to assist me in breaking down their pride, their narcissism. Allow them to come to me like a loyal dog. Allow them to surrender to me and to give me their love, their unconditional love. And you're going to do this, like I said, for 3 consecutive days. Once the 3 days are up, what you're going to see is, you see this coconut? There's cracks around it. Okay. What this represents is that this is within the 3 days, like I said, if on the third day, you don't see this crack, even if it's a small crack, you don't see this, what you're going to do is you're going to work through it again one more day. So on the fourth day, you should see a crack. If there's no crack, then this is a this is basically the saint telling you at this present time, I cannot make that happen for you. Now, it could be two different reasons why he's not wanting to make this happen for you. One of them, it could be that destiny is at play, meaning there's a lesson that you need to learn, or there is something that perhaps your intentions are not as pure as you know, would convince yourself that they are, or perhaps you're doing it for all the wrong reasons. Whatever the situation may be, if you don't see it cracks on the coconut, then that is just the saint telling you it's not going to be done. And in that, at that point, there's no point in you moving forward with the spell work, okay? Now, after the third day, if you do see cracks like we see here, what we're going to do is basically you're going to, let me remove this. So what you're going to do is basically you're going to open up, you're going to open up the coconut. I just put the tape so it can hold together so you guys can see it like that. Give me 1 second. Okay. So what you're going to do now is you're going to open up the coconut and you're going to take out the insides. Okay. Once you do this, what you're going to do is you're going to let it out so it can ventilate, so it can dry up. And on the fourth day, you should be ready to go. Okay. So then we move on to the second phase. All right. Now, where you wrote their name as an example, that's the one you're going to keep. And the other one will just assist you to keep it straight or upright. All right. Okay. So once we are in this phase, which is on the third or fourth day, what we're going to do now is we're going to use the Play-Doh. And before we do that, let me show you guys. You're going to put partner's name and DOB, date of birth, like this. Okay. Then you're going to turn it to the right and you're going to write down your information. Three times going down. Okay, like this. Your information, first name, last name, date of birth, three times going down. Then you're going to turn it to the right 1, 2 times. And you're going to write down your petition. Okay, like this. So when you're writing the petition, it is very important to be to the point. Don't make a whole book. As an example, you're going to write down your partner's information, their first name, last name, date of birth. She is more loving to me. She is extremely devoted. She is compassionate. She wants to be with me at all times. She's not jealous. She's very trusting. Or if you're doing this for a guy, he's very loving. He's very loyal. He's committed to me. And make sure to show your gratitude. I am thankful, Saint Simon, for this blessing. Okay, that should be the last that you write in your petition. Once that is done, what you're going to do now is you're going to get some of the powder or love powders that you're using. You can use come to me powder. You can use pull pull powder. You can use do as I say, follow me boy powder, follow me girl powder, whatever it is that you prefer. Or if you get the pull pull powder or do as I say powder on my online store, it should come out, or it should be something like this. What you're going to do is basically you're going to put some of the powder. You don't need very much of it, only because we are going to strengthen it and empower with the dove's blood. So what we're doing here is we're going to put 3. We're going to put 3 drops. Then you're going to fold the petition like this, coming towards you, then again coming towards you, Then again, coming towards you, always turning. Then again, coming towards you, okay? Like this. Okay, so it should look something like this. I have this ready for my client, but for showing purposes. All right. So with this, what we're going to do is we're going to get the Play-Doh. Whoops. Okay. And what we're going to do is you don't need very much of it. Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to put your intention when you're doing this, okay? When you're rolling it, when you're playing with the Play-Doh, make sure to put your intention behind it. Again, like I said, if this person is very narcissistic, if this person is very stubborn, I am breaking you. You are molding to my hands. Whatever my requests are, you will do as I say. You will gladly follow me wherever it is that I go. You will gladly put your pride, your ego aside. You will be a loyal dog. Really put your intentions when you're doing this with the Play-Doh. I cannot express to you guys how powerful and important this process is when you're doing the Play-Doh, okay? So again, take your time when doing this. Really put that force and that energy. I know that for some of you guys, this could seem a bit drastic or a bit dark, but that's what this type of spell work is, okay? I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. You guys already know how I am. If this is not your cup of tea, then obviously don't watch this video. All right, so once this is done, okay, so once this is done, what you're going to do is you're going to get the petition paper and you're going to push it in, okay, as you guys can see, and cover it, okay. Okay, so it's going to look something like this, and you just keep, you know, pushing it in, so it's gonna look something like this, all right? Okay, once we have this, we're going to introduce it here. Again, like I said, you guys, keep the coconut part that has the information and their name, okay? The other side, we're just going to use to keep this upright or straight. All right. So once that is done, what we're going to do now is we're going to introduce the same ingredients that we used here when we were breaking down their mind. Okay. You're going to put some thyme. You're going to put some of the spirit powder. Like I said, you guys can find all the ingredients on my online store. Okay, now we're going to put some of the love powder. Some of the buckthorn bark. Some of the vervain. And some of the Angelica. Don't need very much of it. All right. So now I'm going to get some of the licorice root. You don't need very much of it. This is powdered. Okay, so once that is done, what we're going to do now is pour more of the dove's blood. Okay. And pour some of the honey. So what you're going to say is, I go around, all around, all within by magic bound. I call upon the spirits, obedient spirits, spirits of love, spirits of domination, spirits of anxiousness, spirits of desespero, or desperate spirits. I ask you to assist me in dominating the mind of, you're going to say the partner's first name, last name, and date of birth. Okay. So once you do that, what we're going to do is now we're going to light the candle. Give me 1 second. Oh. I can't find the matches. Give me 1 second. So sorry, I had the lighter with me instead of the matches. All right, so what you're going to do now is you're going to light the candle, and you're basically going to let it melt. Okay, you're going to pour all the wax into this work, and basically what you're doing is you're sealing it. Okay, really focus and visualize what you're wanting to make happen. It's very important to keep that focus, that, you know, real clarity of what you're wanting and what you're petitioning. So what we're gonna do is we're going to wait for this to completely melt, sealing this work. And once that is done, what you're going to do is the next day, you're going to light another red candle, and you're going to do the same thing. And you're going to do this for a good 4 days, okay? So it's 3 to 4 days with waiting for the saint to tell you if you're able to move forward on the second phase. So that's 4 days. Then you're going to do this process with the melting of the wax 4 consecutive days, okay? And in 4 consecutive days, you're going to be lighting the candle, or a candle, for 4 days, melting the wax and sealing basically this work, all right? Once that is done, what you're going to do is you're going to finally light another red candle, and what we're going to do is we're going to keep the candle upright, and you're going to keep it upright, and you're going to let it completely melt. Okay, so once it has completely melted and all the wax has sealed this work, then it's done. Okay, now we go to phase three, and phase three is lighting San Simon's candle. Keep the candle by this work. So let's say that we have already proceeded with the 4 days of the melting of wax, and we are on third phase, which is the gratitude. We're going to light this candle, Saint Simon's candle, and we're going to say, Saint Simon, I thank you. I thank you for being present in my work. I thank you for bringing to me the petition that I request of you. Here's where you promise whatever it is that you're trying to give to him. I promise you that if you bring this person to me humbled, if you bring this person to me in a loving and caring way, I promise to you that I will light you three other candles. Or I promise you that I will light you a candle with a cigarette. Whatever your petition, whatever comes out of your heart, okay? And you're going to say, Saint Simon, I thank you for being present. I thank you for bringing forth my materialization of this spell work. I thank you for opening the pathway to least resistance. In your precious and powerful name, blessed be. Then you light the candle and you're going to let it completely burn out, all right? So once this candle is completely extinguished and it has finished burning, what you're going to do next, or the next step, would be to get this this work, this seal, and keep it in a place where no one's going to disturb it, where no one is going to. So you can keep it in your altar, you can keep it in your room, you can keep it ideally. What I encourage clients to do is you can use this as an example. If you have a backyard or you have the front yard, you can actually put a plant over it or plant seeds on this. Once they start to grow or bloom, you can transfer this, use it as a plate, and you can transfer it to a pot or a bigger pot so that it can continue giving fruition. Really taking care of it. Now, if you don't want to go that route, you can always just keep it away from anyone. You can keep it, you know, tucked in your closet as an example, whatever. Remember, if you were to ever lose this, or if anyone was to ever disturb this or even mess with it, the spell work is done. It's broken. So you're going to have to redo this, okay? I know this was a rather long spell. It is a ritual itself, and it is a very long process. But I guarantee you guys results. If you really do it from beginning to end, you will be amazed at how powerful your results are. Okay? So I hope you guys enjoy. I send you guys all my love and light, and we'll see each other soon. Bye-bye. Thank you.